Finally tonight, we talk with one of the country's most acclaimed poets, Gerald Stern, as he looks back at more than 70 years of writing verse. Jeffrey Brown has our conversation, part of our occasional series on poets and poetry.
At 87, Gerald Stern has been writing poetry a long time and has been one of the nation's most honored poets. Now he's received a new honor for a collection of some of his earliest works. The prestigious Bobbitt National Prize for Poetry from the Library of Congress is given for the most distinguished book of verse published in the last 2 years. Stern won for his early collected poems. His newest book is called In Beauty Bright, and welcome to you.
Hi, Jeff.
What happened when you look, I want to talk about these early, this early collection. What happened when you look back at the early poems? What did you see?
Well, you know, I paid a lot of attention to it in the last couple of days because I felt it was my duty in terms of this prize to read from that book rather than recent poems. And what struck me was two things, the overwhelming similarity of what I'm doing now and the overwhelming difference.
And on the one hand, on the other hand.
In a certain year, 65/66, I suddenly developed a voice that I've been happy with ever since, and I've never been left alone. I've never had a time when I didn't have five or six poems from that day to this where I'm ready to work at.
You know? I see. So that, in that sense, you feel sort of the same poet. The same,
yeah,
right?
Albeit, you know, you write differently when you're 70 than when you're 30.
You
or
do.
When you're 80, then when you're 50.
What does that mean? How do you write differently?
Well, because you're closer to death, you're farther from birth, your children, if you have them, are older, you have some money.
You grew up in Pittsburgh.
Yep.
You describe walking the streets. You came from a working-class background.
Yeah, that's what I did. I walked all the time, across the bridges.
And through the
tunnels.
And the background was not one of literature and poetry, right?
We didn't have one book in my house, not one book. And we used to get the Pittsburgh Sun-Telegraph, which was a Hearst paper, and we subscribed to Look magazine.
Uh-huh.
And that was the extent of reading material there.
And so when it
Plus
came...
Plus a Bible in Hebrew, you know.
So when it came to... there you were now teaching American literature, and you had to teach yourself in some ways?
I was a prisoner of the library.
Mm-hmm.
And I just spent hours sitting in the stacks on a lighted floor, which gave off some heat, in the main branch of the Carnegie Library in Pittsburgh, just reading and reading. And I just, after I graduated from college, and I did with highest honors, I was really a bright student. I wasn't a major in English. I majored in political science. I was going to be a lawyer. And my poor dad said, well, what are you going to do? Because I was offered all kinds of scholarships. And I said, I'm going to take off a year and read. And that became, you know, 10 years. I lived in Paris,
and
New York, 20, and all that stuff.
Yeah. And then a life of reading and a life of writing. So
just bring us
up in our last minute here, like, bring us up to date. I mean, here, where are you now as a writer, as a poet?
In 2012, I had two books published. This book called In Beauty Bright, which is a book of poetry, and a book of prose called Stealing History, which is published by Trinity University Press.
Mm-hmm.
It's about 300 and some pages, 85 short sections. They're not essays, but they're essay-like, and they're almost like prose poems, some of them. And since I've published this book, I counted the other day, I have 63 new poems.
So you're certainly not slowing down.
I'm speeding up.
In a sense of urgency?
Or
no,
it just
happened?
Just joy.
Just joy.
And there's no joy and sorrow, of course, they go together. And don't they?
I guess so.
It's just what I do. I have another poem, again, that's a recent poem. I don't have it with me. I don't think it's in here. It's called The Mule. And I think of myself as a mule with blinders or blinded. Some of them, they actually blind. And they went in a circle pushing against a stone, grinding corn, grinding wheat. And only I make poems, so I'm a mule. And that was the metaphor I used in that poem.
All right. Well, the honored book is for the early collected poems, 1965 to 1992. The new book is In Beauty Bright. Gerald Stern, nice to talk to you. Thanks.
It's a pleasure to talk to you, Jeff. It really is.
What an inspiration. And you can go to Artbeat to listen to Stern read his poem, The One Thing in Life.